Thank you. Thank you and good afternoon. It's a pleasure for me to be here, almost back home. I'm, as you know, I'm Scandinavian, Swede, and in fact, born and raised in a place very close to where we stand today. So it's a real pleasure to be back. And for me, it actually started in Malmö, and it was here in Scandinavia that I've got the fundamentals relative to leadership, relative to work, the skills of work, the skills of ethics, and the skills of value. And they have been very, very important for me as the base, as I after that have traveled around the world and done many, many things. I've lived in many places around the world, and at every place I've gone, I could use some of the basis of my leadership, but I also to adjust and learn, which then by definition not only develop me as a better leader, but also help to develop individuals in that part of the world to become a better leader as well. And I think that is what is very important. Now, there's a couple of things that we are well known for in this part of the world that is not so strong attribute in skill sets in other parts of the world. And for me, what I have taken with me is basically three things that I have used in the United States specifically, where we have our big headquarters and operation. And the three things I'm thinking of that we are doing very well is consensus, is respect for the individuals, and is delegation of responsibility. And leadership is global. And if you operate like we do, not only in Denmark, in Sweden, in Finland, in Norway, in Iceland, France, Argentina, etc., you need to be very clear in your communication of what is expected. And that's coming back to something I talked about, which is adaptation to differentiation. So you need to make sure that people really understand what you try to accomplish, but communicate it to them in the way they would like to be communicated. You have to make sure you empower people, give them the tools, give them the freedom in order to operate. And if you don't do that, you will not create the environment of innovation, inspiration, and creativity. And that also will then build out curiosity. Curiosity is a key element for you to be successful. Now, differentiation is an important element when you do business around the world. And differentiation is coming to, I will say, diversity, which has an incredible power if you use it. The point is, when there's differentiation, you also need to make sure that you adjust your own style. And I pointed to that earlier, where I think that there was a time, specifically, maybe, at least that was my feeling, that if you worked in an American company, they came around the world and told people how things should be done. No adjustment of the style. It was the American style. I think America has learned a lot since then, and I know myself by experience, as I travel a lot, that when I travel places, I need to be very clear relative to what needs to be accomplished, but I have to tell it in a different way. It's a different way for me to communicate in Japan versus in Germany versus in Chile versus in Norway, Sweden, and Denmark. Now, I will say, to be a little bit critical about the Scandinavians, maybe sometimes it takes a little bit too long time and there's too much consensus. So the point is, you have to use the power of it. You have to provide a tool and get it going very, very fast. And that also, I will say, relative to differentiation in between Scandinavia and United States is what I talked about, differentiation. Differentiation is a given in the United States. It's a given. It's a competitive environment. Pay for performance is very clear. If you perform better than me, you will get more pay. Before I became CEO, I interviewed 35 3-5 former CEOs or sitting CEOs and asked them certain questions via type of nailed down to 5 things that they would have done differently if they became CEOs again. And it was very interesting because you suddenly, in informal discussions, you got very good advices that you could look upon. If it's 35 people saying certain thing that they all said, this is something I should have done differently. I think you have to sit down and think about it.
What was the best piece of advice you got?
I think one, there was multiple, there were many very good advices, right? But one thing that many actually said was that if I could start again, I should clarify the vision for the company almost immediately.
Do you have a structure though where almost anyone within your organization can raise their hand and say, Inge, you know, I think there's a new technology here that we need to look at, or this new technology is going to eat our lunch in this certain market. Can they reach you that easily?
They can reach me, maybe not by just raising the hand and say, here's something that we work today, but we have a process in place with something we call CTOC, which is an organization in the technical community that are rolling up programs. So what they do, you can present, you talk to them, they help you to formalize the idea. They vet it as well to say what is the probability for this to happen, and do we have technology? We have 45 technology platforms. Can we use them in order to come there? If the answer to that is yes, they go to a filter. It's coming to something we call innovation board, which is a 3M internal board, which I'm the chairman of. And we then invest money into their businesses. So we invest those money, we invest in that idea for 2 years. So for 2 years, the company are paying for that investment in that division. After 2 years, you take on the investment yourself. So we give them 2 years of help and support with big money, I would say, in order to get up and going. And then after 2 years, the cost or investment is coming on themselves, and then you have to see if it was such a good idea. But most cases, it is.
What's the success rate of that?
Very good. We have today, I think, 28 programs started, we have killed some of them. So now we have 19. And that's the other thing. You have also to stop some of them. So it's better to stop them early than to type of hang in too long into them.
Inge, thank you so much for joining us. Inge Thulin, the chairman and CEO of 3M.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. That was fantastic.
Thank you.